Hello, folks. We are live, and it is the True Vapor Show. So, it's early in the morning. Got the fine cast of folks here. So, as always, we're going to take it down the line, start reading them off. So, take it away, Dirty.
Hello, you beautiful people out there in YouTube land. I'm hoping you're having a great morning because we are here on the True Vapor Show. My name is Dirty Devo. You can find me on dirtiesmind.com or youtube.com/dirtiesmind. Today, I'm vaping on the Flawless Tugboat Parallel Box Mod with the Tugboat Addy, rocking the Anarchist Tugboat cap. Toot, toot. And inside that, I'm vaping some DIY. And then I'm also vaping the Able and the Mod Father cap. And inside that, I am vaping on some Adore e-liquid. Go check out adoreeliquid.com and enjoy her stuff. Thanks for having me on, guys. Take it away, SD.
And next, we have from the Isles of Portugal, DJ. Take it away, brother.
What's up, wonderful people? I'm Daniel from the JLSB Vapes YouTube channel. Today, I'm vaping on the Smoke Guardian pipe.
Damn.
It is wonderful pipe, so I'm vaping classy today. I'm also vaping on the UL Rafale tank with the VRBA section inside on top of the cuboid. And I'm also vaping on another UL Rafale with the stock 0.2 ohm coil on top of the SDNA 200. And that's it.
Sweet. And next to him, we have that fine gentleman, Mr. Daryl Shernigan.
Hey guys, Daryl Shernigan, Quest for Vape. Today I'm vaping on the UL Rafale with the stock coil on my RX200. I also have the RBA on the Rafale, and then also vaping on the TFV4 Nano on the X-Cube Mini from Smoke, and I'm vaping some Adore e-liquid, Easy Custard.
Nice, nice. And next to that gentleman, we have Andrew.
What's up, folks? Today, let's see, should I go buffet? I'm going to go buffet. So we got the cricket with the messes. Juice box in here. We've got the tugboat with the Modvapa Panda V12. It just sounds ridiculous saying tugboat, DNA 200, and Modvapa in the same fucking sentence. The Cortex with the coral tank. The Vapor Shark with the Patriot. The Anarchist Tugboat Box. Toot toot. With the Kennedy 22 and juice across the board.
Nice. And next to him we have Mark.
Hey everybody. Mark Vaping Fagan here, and this morning I'm vaping on the Atheno Hero mod, Ghost V2, this weird, goofy-looking Luggy mod with the matching tank, and this Azamo L1 with the Velocity clone and a Trinity Glass top cap e-liquid. I'm vaping on, what is this stuff? This is Lupe Fiasco from Yeti Vape. Actually tastes just like Loopy. And I am trying out some of this. Where the hell is that? Where's that last one? Oh, the Pancake Man.
Nope. That'll be it. All right. And next to him, we have Mike.
Holy fuck. Hello, and good morning. Okay. I am vaping on some Dunkin' Donuts coffee.
Nice.
Just straight up. Little extra milk, no sugar.
Always
I'm also vaping on the classy Guardian Smoke. Watson, are you there? Anyway. And there vaping on I actually jumped into Mark's shelf and grabbed his loopy fiasco from Yeti. I'm vaping that in there. Thank you, Mark. I am vaping on the 8 Cigar VT-133 with the most ugliest tank in the world, the Lugi tank or Lucky tank.
Amen.
And there I have the most delicious juice in the world, Adora E-Liquid's Caramel Apple Crisp. I am vaping on the iStick 100 Watt with the Arctic V8 Mini. In here I have just a little bit. I'm trying to kill off the juice. I got some Morning, I think it's called. From
Daily Dose.
What's the name of the company?
Daily Dose.
Yes, Daily Dose, Morning. A little bit left. I got to get more of that stuff. It's good. And also the Minikin with the VF Addy. And here I have Key Berry Yogurt. And yeah, that's it. I got more stuff, but I don't want to drag this on. Thank you for having me. Good morning, everybody.
Thank you for coming on, sir. Next to him, we have Brett.
What up, YouTube? It's Brett here from Southern Gentleman Vape Reviews. You can find me on YouTube at Southern Gentleman Vape Reviews. I'm vaping on the Smoke R80 with the, I think it's the Micro TFE4. How much of a guzzler is this Micro?
Get one hit and it's
not up. As much as the full and the mini.
Really?
Yeah. It's not.
The flavor's better too. I like it better than the other two.
Oh, well, that's surprising. I haven't used it that much. I just got it yesterday. Also vaping on the Luggy with the I think it's the iSub S on top.
Can we see the wheels on that Luggy?
Yeah, really.
There we go. Those are some nice wheels.
No spin.
Daniel.
It's got a locking differential. Yeah.
Chill out with all that box shit over there.
All right. But what did he get? Because he went, oh, shit. He looked at
an SX. Sorry. I got an SX Mini and the silicone sleeve.
Cool.
Oh, okay.
And then I got something from VapeMX, and inside of that box from VapeMX, I got this stuff. I don't know what it is.
Fortune cookies?
Yeah.
Yeah, fortune cookies.
Silicone fortune cookies.
What? Seriously?
Yeah. So, from VapeMX, I don't have
those
their
condoms?
One. I don't
eat
know.
One.
It's,
eat one.
No, it's silicone.
No, eat it. Eat no, it. Those are ears. Elf
Hell
ears.
No.
Those, that's candy.
Those are elf ears.
Taste it.
No, don't put it in make it funnier ass.
Yeah, I only got this. And on the invoice says two metal tubes.
Oh, okay. I messed
and
up
they only sent me this.
Isn't your rubber ears? Holy fuck.
So VapeMX just joking with me.
You can give them, you can give those out at VPX.
Eat
maybe.
Them.
Oh, shit.
There you go.
The hell?
Elf ears.
All
got
right.
Our own little elf.
Hell yeah. All right. Zach.
Wow.
Well, now, how do I follow up elf ears? That,
you're going to have to pull it off somehow.
Well, damn. I wasn't even done.
You setting the bar really high on me. Brett, oh. you called out those elf ears. That makes you the geekiest person on this panel, you know.
Mm-hmm. Agreed.
Those are nice.
Those are hot.
Did you have something left, Brett?
I have one thing left. RX200 and the Raphael tank, and I'm vaping on some blueberry in it. Mm. Yummy stuff.
Nice.
That's it.
Nice. Sorry about that, Brett.
It's okay.
Daniel caused all the confusion on here, so I'll blame
I'm
it on the
rest. I want that package, too.
take it away, Zach.
Okay, I'm still reeling about the ears, but I'll try and remember what I was doing here. So it's the IPv4 with the Z-Pal Coral on it with some Zombies E-Juice.
Ooh.
And then the RX200, which was transferred to a DNA. This is actually sold so that I could pay for my plane ticket. I just have to send it off. with the aromatizer and some, of course, Adore e-liquid. Hashtag Adore 4. And then the Dolphin tank with the nickel coil in it. And in that, I'm always vaping some Philip Rock. Just come on now.
Nice.
That's it.
Oh, man.
He's a classy man.
I think that troll has been trolling everyone's show is back in this room.
Yay!
Last night.
What's his name?
Mr. Dave West.
Dave West.
And he gets up early, man. Shit.
Well, I'm honored you joined the show, so...
Probably not pushing Walmart golf carts right now.
All right, well... Let's take it away, man.
ST, you got the... I know. People waking up early for you?
Damn.
I know, shit. I guess it's on, so... So how is everybody doing out there in chat, on the panel, in the world, out in space, all that good stuff there? I think a few of y'all have had a busy week so far. I know Mark had his real reveal this week, which I hear was a very successful turnout to that. What's your feelings to all that, Mark? I know you're just ecstatic to tell everybody.
You weren't there. I was heartbroken.
Well, I mean, some of us had to work. I'm sorry. I'm trying to pay your bills and mine. So
you could be on your phone. You could have went to the bathroom for an hour or two.
Yeah, I'd have probably got in trouble with my carrier for data usage, but
it was fun and long, very tiring. Well, when I say something's long, it's got to be long. Because I'm king of length.
You didn't start getting it too crazy on there, did you?
No, it was very... Holy Jesus. No, it's very, very mild. It seems there's a new photo of ST out there.
Oh, hell. Yeah.
This is sent by Anonymous. Yeah.
You sure you want to push it my way first?
It seems ST's doing a lot of Pornhub.
Oh, damn.
It was Brian. Brian's the cameraman for your sex dungeon. So.
Yeah, I'm seeing that. Thank you out there, Brian.
Holy shit. Where is he getting this
Oh, goodness.
You look so serious in that photo, too.
Well, I got to be serious about that stuff, so. Oh, man. Well, speaking of all that, I guess there was a pretty big announcement that you're joining up with a new crew.
Yes, Brian and Mike asked me to be on the I don't know, third member or fourth member of the vape team. So that's going to be really, really fun.
So I guessed.
You did? You guessed that?
Yeah, I guessed the other night with Mike.
Sweet. I did not even expect that. I thought Brian was joking with me. So I kind of held off until the end of the joke came, but no, he was serious.
Nice. Congratulations.
That's going to be a lot of fun. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I think y'all will fit together well.
Well, my cameraman just delivered my photo to me. Thank you, cameraman.
I need a scrapbook pretty soon, shit.
Yeah, I know. Well, that'll be pretty awesome right there, all three of y'all on there. So,
hell yeah.
Is that going to lead into... Is that going to be like the only show of the week here pretty soon? Uh-oh.
There we go, right there.
There it is.
Bam!
Ah, shit.
Nice. Very nice.
I'm kissing a penis in that photo.
Hold on, I gotta email that tomorrow. This way you can put it up on your back TV.
My TV.
I also have an announcement.
I got my TV off this morning. Go ahead, Daniel.
Go ahead, Daniel.
I also have an announcement to make. I have everything ready to go to Detroit.
Sweet.
Nice.
Nice. What's going on in Detroit? Why are you going there, and where are you going?
I'm not really sure because I saw some photos from Detroit, and I'm not really sure where I'm getting into. But Yeah, it's VPX Detroit.
Oh, you're not going there to sightsee, you're going there for a vape expo.
Yep, with some of you.
Well, just don't drink the water from what I've been told about a million times in the past week, so make sure we all stock up on lots of water. So it has been confirmed, I believe, that pretty much most of this panel sitting here will be in Detroit. So, Andrew, are you going, or is it still kind of back forth, or I'm putting you on the spot real quick.
I doubt it's going to happen. I seriously doubt it.
I got you.
I wish like hell it could.
Well, you were kind of making the determination whether or not you were going to do that at Foxwood.
Yeah, the better half put it to me as you can go to one or the other, but not both.
I got you.
So.
Well, that sucks because, like, Daniel and myself, we can go to one or the other, too, and we picked VPX Detroit, so now we're not going to get to see it.
I can go to one. I'm not really sure if I could go to the other.
Oh, that'd be sick.
I enjoy foot the bill. Don't worry. We'll take
care of it. Yeah. Mark, are you still doing both?
As of now, yeah. I'm definitely doing Detroit, yeah. And as of now, I'm doing the other one, yeah.
And we also need you to get your room booked, because I know you want to wait till you actually walk in the door of the hotel and say, hey, I need a room. But
my wife's going to make me do it tomorrow, Friday. I do like waiting to the last minute. I don't know why. Something in me just waits to the last minute.
You like the rush.
Yeah, it's like, you got to book it now. What if they sell out? I'm like, okay, I'll book it. So, yeah, I'll be booking it tomorrow. Hopefully there's still rooms left.
Nice. Well, I see Brian and Heathen are out there in chat right now. What's going on, guys? So, what interesting news has been happening this week? Because I've been locked away in a dungeon all week, and I hadn't got to see anything, so...
Nothing, I don't think. I think China's like cooling down because they're going on their little New Year's thing.
When is that officially happen?
I could have swore it was the 31st. I could be wrong though.
29th, I thought.
Oh, 29th. Okay.
I don't know. I could be wrong.
They're still. I forget how it works. I know 1 week, the office workers leave 1 week, and then the warehouse people leave another week. I forgot how exactly. But it's been kind of slow, which is a very good thing.
Could have fooled me. I've had packages showing up at my house the last week. I think they're just dumping everything, pushing it out before they go away, which is nice. But I got to catch up on a lot of shit.
Yeah. So have you been, Mark, you and Mike, been both getting loaded down, I'm certain?
I just been getting, like, messages... And everyone wanting the review done by the 15th of February. Yeah. So I don't know what the 15th of February is when they come back, or I'm not sure.
I got an email that they wanted me to do the Luggy review before the 6th of February.
Oh, yeah, the 6th. Like, yeah, they all these weird dates.
They got some ECF, something on ECF going on, like a big giveaway, I guess, and they want the review... up before the giveaway, I guess.
That's my birthday, though, so I don't know if I'm going to do that.
But I think I'm going to bring the Luggy with me to Detroit. I'm going to pack it up with all my stuff inside it and Luggy with me.
Are you going to put the stickers on there?
Yeah, hell yeah. Do they have a Detroit sticker?
Oh, probably not.
No? Nah, fuck it then.
Are you sure it's pronounced Luggy and not Loogie?
I call it Loogie, too. So. I'm my Loogie on my Luggy.
My so Luggy what? Has a non-slip differential. The wheels don't move at all.
Mike, have you given it any thought of what you're taking as of gear-wise yet?
Nah, I think it's too early because by then there'll be something new out that we're going to want to bring with us probably.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know the vape game the way it is. But I think, I don't know, I haven't decided. I might bring my boxer because I wear boxers, not briefs.
Nice.
So, I
wear Speedos.
And I might bring my boxer mod with me too.
Nice.
Which boxer is that? The boxer
by 133.
Oh, okay. Because there's that other mod out there called the boxer now too.
Oh, that's something else. It's boxer something else. The name, I can't remember the name. Mark knows the name.
Yeah, where the hell did Mark go?
He skipped out on us.
Uh oh.
Sorry, he's I was notified by Brian. I have to.
Oh,
my TV game and advertise.
There we go.
I don't know what I'm bringing either.
Yeah, I know. I was curious to know what some people are going to be bringing.
I normally bring when I go to vape meets, I bring mods that don't require 18650s, like you know lipos or something, so I could just plug them into the wall and charge them.
Yeah.
I bring like two or three of them, so I don't have to deal with bringing a battery charger and shit with me.
Are you bringing your vapor lift one?
I have to find screws for it because I took the I wanted to see the inside, and in order to get the screws out of this thing, I had to like I had to take a drill at it. But I finally got the screws out, but now I can't get the screws are completely shot. So I gotta go get some screws for it, and I might be bringing this with.
You took a drill to a lipo box? That's pretty brave.
Very stupid of me, but there was no other way to get them out. I mean, they were. I don't know how the hell they had these things in there.
Has anybody
blow it up?
Has anybody looked to see whether or not they're allowing bags in the convention or not?
They usually do. The only thing I know, some vape meets they don't like you doing like selling shit out of your backpack or something like that.
Yeah.
But usually they allow you to bring bags and shit like that.
Yeah, VPX New Orleans, you could bring in whatever you wanted.
Okay. Because I want to say I heard through somebody else that they were raising hell about bringing a bag in.
Always go to the gas station, get some Gatorade before you go to a vape convention. Wear some nice shoes that you're not going to get tired of standing on. You know, it's pretty much like a car show.
Does anybody know if like VPX Detroit will be selling alcohol like VPX New Orleans, or was that just a New Orleans thing?
I don't know that one.
I'm pretty sure they all have liquor there.
I'm sure you'll have a bottle in your bag.
That's what I'm trying to plan for. If they're not going to sell it, then I'll throw some vodka in a water bottle and just bring that.
There you go.
I'm not going to walk around there the entire time and not have at least a little bit of a drink here.
You're not going to be selling it? Come on, man. Just set up your own little stand.
Well, no, not officially I'm not going to be selling it, but if you meet me in the bathroom for 35 cents, you can crack on my bottle.
Just get a whole bunch of luggies and roll them around with alcohol on them.
Well, I know technically this will be the first time that I have flown with as much gear as what I'm about to take, but obviously I know it can be done because Nurky did it here flying to Alabama, and he had a pretty big assortment in his bag, so I don't foresee
quite a bit.
Yeah, I don't foresee any problems there. But
so this is a good question, Dirty. So you've flown recently with vape gear. How did you pack it? How did you present it so that airport security would recognize and see what you had? What did you do? What were your arrangements?
I had everything in this. I had this filled out with mods and everything. This is where I keep all the addies and stuff I'm not using. But I had that full, and then I kept everything in my backpack. Juice. I made sure I had all the juices in a Ziploc bag, a clear Ziploc bag that you can see all the juices. My spare batteries, I had it in cases, in the battery cases. I had those all lined up. So basically, I had two carry-on bags. had one little small duffel bag, and I had some stuff in there. And then I had, like, chargers and all that stuff were in there. And I placed all that stuff on top just because I used to travel with my laptops and all that stuff. I just keep it on top so it's easy for me to pull out if anybody wants to look at it. And then same thing with my backpack. I kept everything towards the front end of the backpack. So they wanted me to open it or look at it. I could, but I didn't have anybody look at any of that stuff. I mean, I had my laptops out and my bags went through everything, and everything went through fine. I had no issues. I do say if you are traveling with a tank that you do come with you to the airport and you bring it in, when you get on the plane and you're going to fly, you want to make sure the airflow control is shut all the way off. You want to keep it closed. And if you can, the tank you want to store upside down in your carry-on bag because of the pressure, it's going to push out the hole. So if you can take your tank and have it upside down when it's stored in your bag, if it has juice in it, that'll prevent any leaking issue. But also to be safe too, because mine, I had a Ziploc bag that the mod I was traveling with in the tank that I was vaping on, I put that in the Ziploc bag just in case it did leak. It's only leaking in that bag and not all over everything.
Yeah, they won't let you take 18650s and store them in your undercarriage, you know.
Yeah. Neither liquids.
Yeah.
Now, is there a limit on the, like, is there a limit on the amount of 18650s you can carry or the amount of liquid that you can carry with you?
I had 20 batteries with me, and on the way back, I had two big bags full of juices. So there was no limit on juices or anything. I mean, I didn't have any huge bottles that were bigger than 4 ounces all in one, but I just had a bunch of smaller bottles with me, so I didn't have any issues.
As long as it's at least 30 ml bottles, I think. Don't carry, like, 120s with you.
Last time I checked, 120s, I think it was maybe 100s were acceptable, but not 120s, yeah. So just make sure they're separately, put them all in a bag, but also make sure that if you have a 120, split it out into something else.
Yeah, unicorn bottles, a bunch of unicorn bottles or something.
Yeah, 100 mils or less.
Well, the good thing, too, with us going to a convention, I'm certain that there's going to be a lot of free juice that we can survive on. So I'm not too concerned taking any big bottles with me. But it is good to know somebody that's flown recently and what he's went through with all this stuff. So
Are you saying, ST, that at a vape show you can, like, get away with free juice?
No, don't hold me to that.
I get stopped more for musical stuff that I have with me, like my mixer, stuff like that. When that's in my bag, that's what they want to look at.
Do you think it's fine to carry the battery charger in the other luggage?
Yeah, probably so.
Yeah, battery charger should be fine.
Okay. Yeah, that's not a big deal.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
I would say anything that was valuable to me that I didn't want to lose, I just always carry with me.
When I first flew to Vegas, like, that was my first time ever flying, and I never really understood how stupid it was to vape on an airplane and get caught, and I was stealth vaping on an airplane. When I told people that, they said that's probably the stupidest thing you could have ever done. If they would have caught you, you would have been fucked.
Yeah.
Maybe on the bathroom. Yeah, I never knew that, but it was my first time flying, so.
And I know exactly what Mark was doing. He was doing like this and going.
Yep.
Got my shirt. Because Mark did that at the restaurant down south, so.
It was fun at the restaurant to do that.
The lights were out, and everybody was sleeping, and I'm like, okay. But when I stealth vape, I just blow up down my shirt.
Because if that sets off the sensors, and they just see, like, smoke, and they don't know where it's coming from, they could potentially have to ground a plane. Then nobody's going to be loving you.
Yeah, that was probably the stupidest thing I've ever done in my life. I didn't realize how.
Mark takes a hit, and then all the oxygen masks drop down in front of people.
But they were just really tiny. I think I had, like, one of those little pens on me. They were tiny little. I wasn't even, like, producing any vapor, I don't think.
You sure you didn't have a TFV4 with you?
No.
Cloud chasing?
Baby clouds. Baby cloud chasing.
I bet you,
if you fly out of a well-known airport, that a lot of people are flying into Detroit to go to the convention with. You could probably have a cloud chasing competition on the plane.
On the plane.
Well, we've had a lot of change up on shows for the week. Not that I'm trying to run this in the ground, but Mark, tonight is your official night to start with the new crew.
Yes, tonight is the night. And I guess we'll see in chat if it's going to be a good thing or a bad thing. That's what I'm looking forward to. I want to see what chat's like.
It has to be a good thing.
Oh, I would only
say. Yeah.
Yeah, but there's a lot of love for BK, and I don't want people to think, you know, like, I'm replacing BK or anything like that. So
yeah, we're going to say that in the beginning of the show. I think we'll make a statement to clarify things, I guess.
BK is still unknown.
By the way, what happened with BK?
He's fighting ISIS right now.
Okay. But well, I mean, like if I, like with my show, like when I had Nate on there all the time, Nate was always gone with work and everything, and he was never, you know, he couldn't make it every Sunday. And then ST, he seemed like a right person to, you know, fit the role for Nate, because he was there every single Sunday. So, and people really didn't get butthurt about that. It's just, you got to be devoted to do a show like this, you know. And yeah. I don't know what BK's situation is, you know, I have no idea, but, I mean, he, like people say, he's sick or whatever, so that might be the case, who knows, but you got to be kind of devoted to do shit like this.
BK's tied up in Mark's basement.
Well, also, Project Fog, you know, they've taken on Josh as a new member, which I think is nice for that show, so.
Yeah, that's a really good addition right there.
Yeah. Brian said that Mark killed BK, so.
No.
Dang. He's starting it up early. I know. He's making a good intro for you tonight.
I know, Brian.
Yeah, I'm hearing that too. Somebody's saying there's a lot of echoing going on. Who we got echoing?
Dang. Not me. Not me.
Not me.
For once, it's not me.
Yeah, I don't think it's me.
Not me.
No.
Not me.
Okay.
Not me.
Okay.
Not me.
Not me.
Not me.
We can do this for 2 hours. Shit.
Hey, Bert.
Is it me?
No.
Hey, Mark. What's hey, Mark.
Hey. Hey, Brett. Hey. Brett. Hey, Brett. Brett.
Hey.
I'll very fast, let's make this announcement too for people that might not have caught this. Who's coming on your show Sunday night, Mark?
Matt from Suck My Mod, and he will definitely be there. Along with ST and Brett and whoever else joins the panel.
Me?
Maybe, I'm not sure.
Okay. Is it true? I've heard a rumor that actually, BK is stuck in ST's sex dungeon. Is there any truth to that rumor?
Yes. Yes. Could be. All right. Well, if everybody looked at the title of the show, where do we go from here?
Oh, there's a title to the show?
I don't know. Or where do we go next? Hell, I don't even know. Yeah, where do we go from here?
Matt's definitely coming on. I was hanging out with him yesterday. Yeah, my hair actually got shorter. I cut it yesterday. But, yeah, he's coming on.
Nice. So you, Matt must be pretty tall, right, since you're tall?
Oh, yeah. He's a
Matt
lot
is taller
than you would think.
He's taller than me.
He's got to be at least, like, 6'5"?
Damn.
I'd say 6'3", 6'4". He's definitely got a couple inches on me, and I'm 6'1".
Yeah, he's taller than 6'2". I told him, I was like, you're a lot taller than I thought, and he was like, you are too.
Well, how tall are you, Brett?
6'2".
Okay.
Brett's lying. That motherfucker never heard of his ass.
Of course.
Didn't know who the fuck you were.
That was the joke. Sorry, I've got to explain it to the people down in Alabama.
Yeah, at least those people down in Alabama know how to get a real haircut. Look at that shit on the side of your head. Like you're about to take flight.
Oh, it's all now. The show went so well.
Did you just wake up, Brett?
Yeah, I did, actually. Thank you.
Are you growing your hair back, Brett, to like full length or what?
Oh, yeah, full length, even bigger than before. I'm bigger, going better. I'm going to get a perm, and I'm going to grow it as a fro.
Nice.
Did he say he's getting a perm?
Yeah.
Dude, Brett with a jerry curl, that would be badass.
Smooth sailing.
So I have a question. I'm curious as to what's going on with Mike's camera angle.
I had noticed a little difference going on there. It looks like it's been pushed back somewhat.
Yeah. No, I think he is trying to make to get some place for a new TV, maybe in the corner.
He's facing the lounge.
Like, this is good, or should I put it back on top of my laptop right in front of my face? I don't know what to do.
I liked it better when it was up close. Because it sounds like you're
far away from the microphone.
Yeah, there's a lot of not echoing, it's just like a lot of distance between you and the mic.
Yeah, I got to figure out something. I got to bring it closer.
I think you're getting ready for your new 80-inch TV to go up on the wall, and you're just trying to get everything placed right.
I'm putting a big screen TV right here.
Hell yeah.
It's going to be a curved 4K, right?
Yes. I'm going all out with mine.
Oh, man.
I might actually be in the TV doing the show.
Ooh, damn, that'd be cool.
There you go.
That would be cool.
I'll be like in two televisions.
That would be awesome out there.
Two screens.
Got all kind of shit going on.
You should talk to Homeboy Josh about like jumping off the screen and onto real life. That would be cool.
Mm-hmm.
Does this Lupe, Mike, taste like Loopy to you?
Not really. There's something missing. There's one, I don't know what it is that I think, I don't know. There's something, it's almost the same, but the background, there's something different about it. I think there was, I think Loopy had a little more custard in it.
Oh, you think?
Nice.
That Yeti?
Yeah, Yeti.
They make a crunchberry custard that's out of this world.
Yeah.
Phenomenal.
I think I have that one right here.
It's so good.
Their Chimpo, that's like a banana walnut, is delicious too.
Yeah, so far I've been trying their e-liquids. They're pretty good.
Sasquatch yogurt is pretty good too.
So you about to break out the sound effects there, Brett? All right, let me get this out. So the title, since I only get like about a few minutes on my drive home to actually think about something other than work, it just kind of hit me like, where do we go next with vaping? Meaning, not what we want to see come out in product-wise, but how can you make these products any better, or how could you tweak them any better than what they stand at right now?
I got it.
And this is a serious thing. We ain't bullshitting. So.
No, I got it.
Okay.
Stickers.
What?
Stickers.
Stickers.
Stickers. Yeah. Stickers. We want more stickers.
I think every mod should come with
stickers.
Come with stickers.
Yeah. Stickers.
The lucky mod.
All right. Well, then y'all answer the question. I'm done.
I think the only way for these mods to get any better and safer is if some regulation's in place. And since nobody is really for regulation, then I don't ever see it happening.
Gotcha.
I don't know. I've seen. I don't know if you guys remember this. I can't remember who I was talking to about it, but like a new type of atomizer where it's like stainless steel and it goes like this and the juice just goes on that and that vaporizes it. Yeehee is actually coming out with some kind of totally new style of atomizer, similar to what I was describing the other day. So my thoughts on it is that we're going to drop wire. And over the next year or two, we're gonna like eliminate wire as a necessary part of vaping.
No more wire?
No, you still have wire, and there'll still be plenty of people building on their ancient K-funds and stuff, but but nonetheless, like, at moving forward, I think because the wire creates a lot of complexity in building coils and maintaining coils and stuff, that if we were to simplify the whole coil prospect, that the people might pick it up easier.
So anybody jump in on this. What is the perfect device? What would be the perfect device? I mean, I know we all have, can say, but what is the perfect device that could be made?
I think one that doesn't even require cotton. It's just a juice, an atomizer, and it just bursts steam into your mouth. That's what. Like, how does a nebulizer work and stuff? How do these things work to create vapor forever without needing a replacement? There must be some other way to do this as well.
Perfect. Wait, you said the perfect mod or atomizer?
Let's do the mod portion first, because we have to go hand in hand with both. But what would be the perfect mod?
Mark's vapor lips.
Noisy cricket.
Damn.
The luggy.
The luggy. No, I really like Mark's vapor lips mod. It's got a 3300 mAh battery, correct?
Yeah, it may be a little big for some people, though.
I'm not going to say that.
Go ahead and say it. Brett likes them big.
I mean, I don't think there could be a such thing as a perfect mod because everyone's tastes are different. So I don't think it's even possible.
And two, what I think perfect, what's perfect now could change in 6 months when something else comes out. I'm like, oh, that could be perfect. Because my perfect vape was last year is completely different than it is this year. So.
Okay, well, that's kind of where I'm getting at, though. Where do you think that one could be tweaked to a point that there's no more engineering that could be put into it to make it any better?
Never.
Yeah, I would like to see mods like the DNA 200 where you can do upgrades over USB and have it to where, you know, on the website you can download like profiles for certain atomizers. Like, you plug in your USB port and you can download a profile for your, I don't know, your crown tank. You can download a profile for whatever, you know. And you don't have to fuck around with settings all the time. It's already kind of like pre-done for you.
Yeah.
That'd be kind of cool.
I actually think Daniel has that set up on his website.
Yeah, he does. But it'd be nice to have like a lot of mods, you know, like other than the DNA 200 offer that.
True.
Yeah, like let the manufacturer do some of the work and they're putting out a product. Let them create profiles, program the thing to come to accommodate at least the most popular best-selling stuff out there so that, yeah.
And make it where it's like wireless because people hate plugging shit into their computer. Make it like Bluetooth or something to where you can just, you know, download the profile from your computer over Bluetooth or something.
I think the perfect chip would be the DNA 200, but to have the same thing like what the iStick has, where you press that one button that goes into temp control. Instead of like going into temp control with the DNA device, you got to press the up and down button and then go inside. There's like a third button on there. And also for you to be able to do stuff with your cell phone. You know what I'm saying? For it to connect to your cell phone, maybe Bluetooth, and you could adjust all your settings that you need. Yeah.
This thing is really cool. The Bluetooth, the app that you get for the Smoke X Cube, and I only have the MIDI, but I was playing around with this for the last couple of days, and I fucking love that.
Yeah, that is a really cool app. But, like, not that I'm trying to push this Vapor Lips mod or anything, but I remember when I got this, they told me that there is an option for a third button on the DNA 200, and that they can do it with a third button, and I'm not sure what the third button would be, but I think you can like, configure a third button on there.
Hmm. What would the third button do?
I mean, you could put it into temp control like immediately, because putting this into temp control is kind of, or going through the presets. I think they said you can configure it to do let that third button do whatever you want it to do, but I'm not positive.
What I want would be a DNA 200 that has Bluetooth, that has an eScribe app. And basically you just hook it up and you change your settings. I mean, you want to vape on the Crown, you just click on your Crown profile and it changes automatically. I don't really care for touchscreen. I can just see that going wrong in somebody's pants. No pun intended, but
I think it would be kind of cool to have like a screen like the L1 and then have like, I don't know, like soft, not as deep as eScribe, but something kind of like eScribe to where you can just go in there and do all the shit on the screen. That might be kind of cool.
Maybe like a series of questions that it scrolls through and you go, yes, this, no, that, turn that on, turn that off. It's easier.
Some of these mods need to be a little bit easier for some of these people because some of these mods are just, they're really confusing. For instance, like the home record. That's a good example right there.
Well, do you think that eScribe should be a little bit more simplicity to it than what it is?
Oh, yeah, most definitely. I think they need like a basic, they need like two interfaces, one like more advanced like they have now, and then like a basic one for people that are just want to, you know, hook up their shit and not have to Google everything and figure out what this does and what that does. Just have
setup. They should have one that's set up with the profiles already there, like the way Joytech's doing it.
Yes.
And then have it where you could also change all that, you know, just like Mark said, two different...
Right, so it comes already done, and then if you want to change it, you can... The work you put in is if you want to tweak it, but you could just pick it up, vape on it without... I would like to see automatic sensing of the actual... If it's nickel, it reads that and it puts you in the nickel profile. If it's stainless steel, it reads that. And then it asks you, do you want this profile? That would be good, too.
Yeah. Oh, Dwayne brings up voice control mods. Vape on.
Vape, bitch.
Speaking of Dwayne. Dwayne, what the fuck?
That's a different Dwayne.
Wrong Dwayne.
Oh. But did any of you guys get this? This just showed up last night, the RBA for the... I sub from Inikin.
Yeah. I didn't look at it though.
It's really easy.
I've had mine for like 2 weeks now, I think. I haven't even tried it.
Let me hold this up. It's wacky.
But you know what, Daryl? I find that it's easy as shit to build on.
Okay.
Like it looks weird, but dude, it's this right here is what makes it so easy.
Okay.
That little tool, Daniel has a really good video on how to build it.
Who's Daniel? He's not here.
Yeah, where is Daniel?
I just looked at it and said, okay, that's complex. And then I figured I'd pick it up over the weekend when I have some time. But it looks cool. I mean, it's definitely different.
Yeah. I just like it because you can tell you just place the coils right in there, put them through the holes, screw them in, and I think it's pretty ingenious. But I wish they would have made it vertical, sort of like the Rafael. You know? I would have liked it vertical.
It's nice. It's nice that they came out with an RBA, because that's the one complaint we all had. Like, we like the tank's great. It's a great starter. It's a great beginner or step up. And then an RBA was the only thing missing, so now they got that. It's nice.
Well, who's actually, other than Daniel, which is not here, who's actually vaped on it?
I have.
What do you think about it?
I like it. The wicking, it takes a couple of tries to get the wicking right, but once you get the wicking right, it works just as good as stock coils. Okay. You know. Maybe not as good as the Clapton coils that they have for the iSub, but it definitely, I mean, it works.
Nice.
But I mean, like Daryl said, it's a beginner / upgrade from, you know, like a starter kit tank. So it's not your TFV4. It's not going to be a production machine, you know. Yeah. It's but the flavor's good off of it. The production's decent for what it is, and it's easy as shit to build on.
Does it come with like a few pre-made coils to go in already, or?
Yep, two.
Okay.
It's got this whole kit, and there's two pre-made coils. That red handle, that's the tool. It's got a screwdriver. It's got this little screen cap. Yeah, cotton. Bunch of screws and O-rings.
Gotcha.
I didn't want to wrangle with it yet, but I was pleased to see it show up.
Someone posted this on my Facebook page. Let me see if you guys can see it. Do you guys see that or no?
Nope.
Yeah. No. You're not seeing it?
Oh, oh, there we go.
I see now. Yeah.
Yeah, the new ceramic coil by Kanger.
Nice.
Yeah, it looks like it kind of looks like the Dolphin in a way.
Yeah.
Hmm.
It is definitely like the Dolphin.
Yeah.
It looks identical.
Yep. Interesting.
I don't think this one you could take apart. I could be wrong though. I haven't tried it, but so it looks like the ceramic thing is going to start taking off.
But if you look closer, looks like it has an unscrewable piece on the top.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
I mean those dolphin heads on that dolphin tank, they're pretty cool. I mean, I like the tank is what I really didn't like the most. It was the tank was kind of shitty, but the idea of the coil was really nice. And I don't have nothing against ceramic. If I vape it and I don't notice any kind of like negative side effects or anything, I don't mind vaping it. But if I start getting sick or nauseous like Daniel did, then of course I'll stop vaping it.
No, I didn't got really, really sick. The three different days I vaped on those ceramic coils from the Vaporesso, one of the days I was actually on G-Spot. I'm on G-Spot all the time, but anyway. I started to have my throat completely clogged and completely screwed. The three different days I've had on those coils, but it could be just me being allergic to that type of coils. But if I'm allergic to ceramic, maybe it means that some particles are being released from the ceramic.
There was actually a subscriber of mine sent me an email and told me, hey, the Vaporesso, there's like a second part to that story. So he directed me to a Grim Green did a video following up. So apparently Vapor Shark tested the Vaporesso coils, and there were particles. And then I guess Vaporesso fixed it, and then Vapor Shark tested the coils again, and there were no particles. So, you know, what you were – it wasn't your imagination. They were giving off particles of ceramic. Now maybe they fixed. They say they fixed it. Vapor Shark tested it. So
yeah, some of the ceramic coils, like, they'll make me wheeze sometimes. They'll like trigger my asthma, and they'll make me wheeze, and it makes me think that there are particles being released from there. Like when I did the review on the Vaporesso or whatever, and I kind of crumbled up that coil, you could see how, like, you know, all those little particles just kind of crumble up, and yeah. But when I broke apart that coil with the Dolphin, it didn't crumble up into like little tiny particles. It kind of just cracked, and it was a little bit different from the Vaporesso one.
By the way, can we trust Vapor Shark? They had a really serious breach on their website releasing passwords in the past, so I don't know if we can fully trust Vapor Shark.
Well, that's their merchant. Hopefully not them.
I'm kidding.
I don't know. Whole drama scene was just meh.
Well, knowing that about ceramic coils, especially like in Mark's case, you say, you know, sometimes it makes you feel funky or whatever. That doesn't scare you enough to say, hey, I don't really want to mess with any type of ceramic coils, because just knowing that it's a hit and miss type thing. Or are you still just kind of fine with the hit and miss off of it?
I'm still just experimenting, because there's like different ones, and like I'm more comfortable with the ones on the Dolphin tank than I am the Vaporesso tank. But I'm just like I said in my video, it's just vape at your own risk. If you notice anything different when you're vaping, don't vape it. I mean, you know, everyone can do tests and this and that, but I don't know. I don't believe none of the tests until they're actually done by a legit, like, who did it? Vapor Shark? How do they do the test, you know? Like, they have a video, or I mean,
they released the test results from the lab that they submitted the stuff to, who it was subcontracted to, some place called MVS.
Okay. Well, I mean, yeah, that's just one tank, and they're, and the Vaporesso design is much different. So, you know, I think they would have to test a few others. I mean, I'm kind of, one day I'm against the ceramic coils, and then the next day I'm for them because the flavor is so damn good on them.
My problem with all of that is do the fucking testing before you ship it out to reviewers and customers, because a lot of people bought those tanks without knowing. So why do you have to wait until people complain or raise the question and then do your improvements? Get it right the first time. This isn't the downside to being wrong on that is fucking health issues.
Yeah.
Are you talking about the Altus right now?
No, the Vaporesso.
I know somebody on the panel had a problem with the Altus.
As far as the ceramic breaking up?
No, just not releasing enough information.
Oh. Zach?
Yep.
Zach's Zach, in trouble.
Zach, what? have you heard any more from what's his face?
David?
Yeah.
No, I haven't heard anything more from him as far as that, but I haven't contacted him again either to ask him any more questions.
So is your look on the Altus different now after talking to him, or do you still have the same, like...
Well, on the Altus, I was never really commenting on the Altus itself, mostly on the company behind the Altus and that guy being the front man of the company. I was calling kind of... It all smelled fishy to me, and he was like a con man, in my opinion. But after talking to him and grilling him on the different subjects, yeah, my opinion of him has changed. I don't own the tank, so I can't really still say. I would like to use the tank a bunch and then examine it under a microscope myself so I can verify what I think it should look like or what damage takes place, see if there's any micro cracks myself.
Yeah, I plan on taking my Altus tank, my $120 tank, and butchering it this weekend with a Dremel and opening up the juice channels on it.
Right, she ought to do a live feed on that one.
Yeah, destroying a $120 tank. So I think that's what's really fucking that tank up are those juice channels.
Can you make it 6 hours?
I could try. I'll do my best as long as possible.
So I have an example of, like, it's not vape-related, but we... All right, I was complaining to my wife that because we have central air conditioning in our house, that ever since they put that in, the ductwork that they run these cooling vents throughout the house are covered with these sleeves, and there's this granular fiberglass insulation in there. And I was just like very runny, like I had hay fever for weeks. And my wife, no problem, nothing. No reaction, and I was like, I'm telling you, there's fucking fiberglass. So I got an air filter, like a kick-ass. I spent like $400 on an air filter. And 2 days after I started it running, I took the filter out, and it was like completely gunked up with this granular insulation. And I'm like, I told you so. But she didn't have any reaction to it at all. But for me, it made me wheeze. It made, you know, itchy, and my eyes were watery and all that shit. So some people are more sensitive to things than others. But that doesn't mean that it's not there, and that doesn't mean it's not giving you a problem. So you may not notice it, and that's my issue. Okay, some people are vaping on these different things, and they don't notice, and it's fine. But, you know, some people are going to be more sensitive, maybe pay closer attention to what's going on. But ceramic is ceramic. Hopefully, I mean, I like the Ceramicus tank from Vapeston. I didn't have any issues with that. A couple of others I did have some issues with, and I can tell that my throat gets a little scratchy. I reserve my opinion on these things until more people have been guinea pigs and used them. So the jury's out for me on ceramic.
I should mention that, too. During that conversation with David, he didn't so much call out other products specifically, although we kind of did, me and Daniel. But when he started explaining how the ceramic and the wire heats up and expands at a different rate, you know, just sticking tungsten wire in ceramic is almost definitely going to cause cracking because the different expansion rates. That's sort of what he was saying the Altus overcomes. He's like formulated the ceramic and the tungsten to expand at a very similar rate, is what I understand. I don't know, obviously. But I do intend to look at this dolphin coil now that I've gone through a use of it and see if there is any microfracturing or any fracturing that takes place on a small level after just a few uses or after I try and dry burn it.
I love you. Will you have my baby?
Yeah, so at the end of the day, pretty much ceramic, vape at your own risk. That's,
like everything else.
Yeah, pretty much.
True.
Vape at your own risk. But I mean, like Canthal and stainless steel, many people have been using it for years and years, and we don't see any health scares yet. So ceramic is, how new is ceramic? Well, ceramic's not that new, but ceramic coil, well, not ceramic coil, but what was back in the day? What, Genesis atomizers, ceramic wicks, I think?
Yes.
People were using those ceramic wicks. Those things were nasty looking. I'd never used those things.
Well, you had the ceramic wick, and then you had the ceramic material in the cotton of, like, the, what, Atlantis tanks.
Ceramic cups that go in RDAs. And so ceramic's been around for a while. It's just they're now implementing it into a coil.
Yeah, the thing about the Vaporesa tank that I had a problem with was that the flavor was great when the wicking was right. Because I kept having wicking problems, and I'd get a dry burn, and that was awful. Awful, awful. And then I would get great flavor off of it when I wasn't getting dry burns.
You could also use Atlantis coils in that Vaporesso tank. It's a nice tank. I like the mod. I like the tank. I even wish maybe, well, I guess they don't have to make Canthal coils because you could just buy Atlantis coils. Interchangeable.
That's true. I got a tank recently that uses Atlantis coils.
What'd you get?
I forget what tank it is.
Thank you very much. Very useful information.
The Mod Vapa is a special kind of coil.
Yeah, made by a special kind of people.
It's a naked coil.
No, it's called a gangster coil.
Gangster coil. Oh, no, there's the Riptide. Or the Driptide. The Amigo Riptide, Driptide, something tide. I keep having wicking problems with this as well. Looks a lot like the Crown.
Anybody get this one? Yokozuna?
I was going to ask the same.
From Japan, yeah. How does that vape, Daryl? I know the coils were kind of small on there.
Vape's great. It's a 15 to 30 watt coil, and then they have a like a 30 to 50 watt coil.
Is that a Joytech coil?
It looks to be an Ego 1 mega coil.
Why don't you tell everyone how you fill it?
Yeah.
So you can bottom fill, or you can use the K-Fun-esque fill screw at the bottom.
Oh,
they say you can bottom fill it. It's got, you just can't fill it above these like wicking slots.
Yeah, the fill hole with the screw is there in order to you to completely fill the tank and no wasting space inside.
Yeah, it's a second option for filling.
Yeah,
it's you don't have to option. Use it if you don't want to.
Beautiful tank though. It's like nice, very very nicely.
It reminds me of the Goblin Mini in looks.
Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah.
You see the spitback it has?
No, it's got like those it's got a weird baffle, like.
That's what I mean. The spitback protection. I meant to say.
Yeah. It's pretty cool.
Cool.
Let me see if I could show that.
Is it made in Japan?
No, it's made in China. It's designed by a Japanese company, though.
Oh, okay. I didn't know.
See that? How the chimney is blocked off? It is a tight draw. And it's a 30. This is the 30 watt, the 15 to 30 watt coil. So, if you like to vape like that,
I noticed the airflow control ring was pretty loose. Is it loose on yours?
I'm not gonna say it's tight. I'm not gonna say it's loose. It doesn't have any clicks or anything like that. It's just a slide.
Okay.
Mine's not particularly loose.
No, mine is regular. Not loose. Not super tight.
Okay.
Just looks right. Like the Goblin Mini.
It does. It does just look a lot like the Goblin Mini.
Yeah, they I like it because it looks like an RTA, you know, has an RTA look.
Yeah.
They told me this one is going to be a new and sexy approach to the Moth to Lungers.
Okay.
I don't know. I haven't tried yet.
I'll agree with that.
Somebody in chat is asking, is it quiet? Is it a quiet vape or is it loud?
Let's see. Was that quiet?
The loudest.
It's, I mean, it's not silent. You're vaping.
Yeah, nothing's out there quiet.
It's not terribly loud. It's all right.
Thoughts on the K-Fun 3 Mini? I would be all for the K-Fun 3 Mini, but the 19mm design's kind of just, I don't know. I'm not really excited about it anymore. Same I wish it was 22.
Too tiny.
Is that one out yet?
I think Vapor Shark's selling.
Oh, are they? Okay. I know the Plumes of Hazard had
Flomesto
on there. But I'm hoping they come out with two different versions, like a 19 and a 22, or a 22 and a 25, or maybe a 25. I know that their last K-Fun that was that small, I forget what was the name of that K-Fun they had, that was really small like that, like 19 or something. I forgot.
What about my Mod Vapa?
Right when I'm inhaling.
Daniel, you get a haircut?
Yes.
You're looking no sexy hit. This morning. Or you this afternoon.
Daniel's getting ready for the trip.
He's practicing.
There he is.
Have you been to the U.S. before, Daniel?
No, I haven't.
Oh, damn.
It'll be my first time.
Well, Detroit is not really part of the U.S., so don't get all discouraged when you say
that. Yeah.
But I'm just joking. The Detroit peoples, I'm just joking.
But it's really close to Canada, so maybe one of the days we can hang out on Canada.
Detroit is like the United States' Tijuana, but without all the fun.
Who's going to volunteer to give Daniel a tour of 8 Mile and Eminem's trailer park?
Damn.
ST.
ST might be strapped. He could do that.
I don't even know if ST being strapped would want to do that once. Oh, man. Daniel, how long are you staying for?
I'm going to arrive day 2 of March, and I'm going to get back at day 7 of March. Okay. So, 5 days.
Thank you for calling Pizza Hut. Take out our delivery.
Yep.
Oh, wait, take out our delivery. Never mind.
Did you say, Daniel, did you say you'll be there March 2nd?
Yes, March 2nd until March 7th.
I thought you meant the second day of VPX. I thought you meant you were coming in on Saturday. Oh,
no. I need to help them setting up the booth.
Just go to back page and click on Detroit if you get bored and lonely at night during the week.
Yeah, because it'll be a couple days before we get off in there, so you're going to have to entertain yourself there for a day or two.
Daniel, if you want, I am available if iJoy would like me to hang out at the booth and vape baptize iSolo Minis, because I performed the first on-air vape baptism of a mod on the iSolo Mini.
Nice. And Daniel, I think, did say that everybody on the panel will be getting free mods from him, so... Thanks again, Daniel. Thank you.
Well, he's done.
Thank you, Daniel. I want it signed.
No.
I won't.
Don't screw me.
Put my logo on there, Daniel, please.
Hey, Daniel, did you see this?
Yes, read the last line.
And explanation?
Mr. Rye Guy in chat, I already answered your question.
Ceramics is particularly?
Oh, oh yeah. Removed the last line?
I seen that last night. I was like, what the hell is this?
The hell is it?
You hadn't seen it?
No, no, it isn't.
Look.
It's just a joke.
Particular YouTube vape reviewer hospitalized.
Yeah.
Hospital.
Read the last
particular? Brett, I think you misread that, buddy.
Popular YouTube.
Yeah.
Yeah, YouTube, the popular bro? is wrong, but
is that real?
No, read the last paragraph.
This is 100% real.
No, what, read the last paragraph.
Yeah, right, if you've read this far, then read below.
You didn't realize when it said popular YouTube, you know, that it was a joke?
That's fucked up.
No. He's clearly being sarcastic and making fun of mainstream media. None of these incidents were related in any manner with the wording... Yeah. People will post it as truth and not research any part of it.
Yeah. Please don't launch that rumor again. Yeah. I got Mac from Suck My Mod texting me asking if I was okay. Yeah. Yeah, on Facebook.
Are you alive, Daniel?
Yeah. You could have really blew up your channel if you would have done a video from live from the hospital.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, freaking, I got on Facebook yesterday, and Shane, of all people, had shared that. And I was like, what the hell is this? Until I read into it a little bit. So.
Yeah.
But there was that one week when we had the show, and Daniel wasn't on because he was sick. And then we were just kind of cutting up, making jokes about, oh, you ate too much of that syrup.
Well, let's call it what it is. Fagan started that one off, so if you got any extra views out of it, you can thank Mark.
I didn't think people would actually believe it.
They didn't believe anything.
Damn.
Daryl, I just rebuilt this iSub RBA section, and it's vaping pretty nice.
Awesome. Awesome.
Yeah. So, has anybody got anything new and exciting? I know I haven't.
No, I haven't either.
Stickers.
I got the Smoke Guardian, and I'm loving it. And today I got the SX Mini ML Class.
Where's the other one?
Which one?
I thought they were sending it in
Q. It's not. They told me it's not ready yet.
Mike has it, though.
It's pretty nice.
It's in his other room.
So my wife's using it today with the IPv5. Stop the devices before I review them.
You like to send her out on the town with it first and then?
Yes.
But, Mike, I have the IPv5S.
Damn.
Oh, nice. Man. I believe you, too.
So do y'all know of any new stuff that you're getting before the Chinese New Year kicks in? Anything special?
I got this badass Modvapa Box XT.
Modvapa.
You know what the best part about this Modvapa is? That the iSub tank and the drip tip.
Well, my lucky mod shits all over your Modvapa, all right? Mine comes with decals, a whole package of decals.
Yeah, but mine has lucky a fucking light. 3 second. Mine has a 3 second delay, so it gives you time to get ready to vape.
Well, mine has wheels on it. If I ever want to like pull it around and cart it with me, I can just wheel it around.
This thing seriously has a noticeable delay. Like, it's 1 2.
Have you put it in a temperature control in nickel with a canthal wire on it?
I don't know how to.
Works pretty well.
With canthal.
Oh, so it's taking pages out of the own record?
No, not at all.
It's like it's just as, the menu on this thing is just as complicated.
It does temp control on every wire, except it's not supposed to. And the tank leaks like a sieve.
That's a feature.
Yeah, that's a benefit.
Leaks like a pregnant woman.
That's the auto-dripping feature.
I think that device is part of the Kimson family.
I think the Panda V12, its water just broke. Going everywhere.
Let's see. Temp control on Canthal.
It works.
Wow, it actually got it up to 590 degrees.
Device of the air.
No, it didn't.
I planned on spending the entire weekend designing and dressing up my Lucky Mammoth stickers.
The whole entire weekend?
Hell
the
yeah.
whole 48 hours of Friday or Saturday and Sunday?
Look how many stickers there are here. I could have days and days of enjoyment.
You Mark, I'll pay for a stamp if you'll send me that Ferrari, so I can put it on this Modvapa, because this thing is, dude, dope.
Oh, Andrew, you should have a package coming soon, probably hopefully in 3 days.
What is it?
That will be determined when you open it.
Is it? Did you send it to the shop or?
Shop.
Okay.
Yep, and you got a sign for it.
Oh, damn.
Got a sign for it? It ain't sign for it.
It's got some valuable luggage in there.
That could be interesting.
If my kid finds these stickers...
Oh, you're screwed.
Oh, they're gone.
The FDA is going to ban stickers as well.
Yeah.
Brittany, I would never let my son have these stickers.
They'll be all over that new bunk bed he's supposed to be getting, right?
Yeah. I keep hearing about that every day. There's a single child, he wants a bunk bed. I can put my mannequin on the bottom bunk then.
What is that coming into play?
I don't know. I found one that was only like one town over. She only wants $50 for it, but it doesn't have a face.
Oh.
Angela, if she can, like, you know, if she does good makeup, if she could do a face, but she's not sure.
You put Brian's face on it.
Yeah, there we go.
There it is.
So I got to find a face.
Just draw one.
But then I'm debating, do I want a mannequin or do I want a bigger TV? It's a tough choice.
Oh, my gosh. You're really going to let that shit set in on you, aren't you?
I don't know.
About TV size.
You need to get a Murphy bed for your son, and just when he goes to sleep, just fold it up.
That'd be sweet.
Sweet.
Put him in there when he's bad.
Well, now look, if you get a bigger TV, where are you going to put it at? Because you've already got that strategically placed. You're going to have to move a whole lot of stuff, aren't you?
Well, that little shitty shelf I have above it, I'm getting rid of that because I need I want to put up a large shelf to display all my beautiful mods that I don't use. So I think the TV's gonna stay there. It took me forever to put the wall mount on my wall, and I'll be damned if I can have that wall mount off.
Yeah, why don't you just put the other TV over the top of the other TV?
There we go. I can super glue it.
A double TV.
Oh, yeah.
Then Brian will really have to step his game up.
I got an idea.
I could do a game.
To your left, where you have all those, your shelving with the devices, put a TV there, but take a picture of your devices. So this way, you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's not a bad idea.
There you go.
Have a virtual shelf.
Yeah.
I would just wait for the day that Mark goes to reach over there and grab something and, sticks his hand through the fucking TV, though. Where's my SX thing? Fuck!
See, I think that is a perfect thing right there, and I should make some money off of this. We all know that the company Fatheads are. We need a Fathead that looks like a wall full of mods.
Now, can I just get a Fathead of Mark and Mike and all the rest of the guys on the panel?
That could be arranged.
They'll just come hang out with me.
I just want to display my like cool looking mods, like not just you know, like the unique looking ones, like the bigger box and shit like that.
I've got an entire wall right over here that I can. I intend on putting fat heads all over, like a Mark fat head, a Mike fat head. I don't know if Brian. I mean, Brian's got a big enough head as it is. I don't know if his would fit on the wall.
Mark, are you trying to big boy your TV with another shelf?
Yes, I am. I was supposed to do it last week, but I didn't do it.
I got to make a nice big poster so you can put up on that wall.
I'm like Vape's poster?
Yep, in Heavy's shop. Her wall looks too empty there.
No, put Dirty's poster on there.
Oh, I'm going to put all of them up.
That wall is empty.
Any posters that my reviewer... family, the reviewer family makes will go on the wall in the shop.
I think what Mike's envisioning is just a huge, massive hit that shit sticker that takes up basically that whole wall right there.
The whole wall, yes. How much for the whole wall?
I think what we need to do is get life-size fat heads of each one of y'all, and I'll just have like. You know, get the fat heads made with your arms out, and then I'll just put them right next to each other all along the wall, so it looks like y'all, you know, you're all arm over shoulder.
Oh, yeah, put Dirty's poster right there. If somebody could present that.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
I just ordered one last night. I didn't order any more than one. I just want to see what it's going to look like as a poster.
Now, is the splat in the corner, is that representing a shit stain or a blood stain?
It could be anything your mind thinks it could be. It's dirty. It could be mud. It could be semen that's been brewing and steeping in a Vaseline jar for a few years.
Steeping.
Oh, gosh.
Let your imagination run wild.
Apparently that wall's supposed to be painted for cloud comps, but nobody's done it yet.
Yeah. It's already marked off. Shut up, Brittany.
Yeah, paint like some like markers on it, like a measuring thing, like every foot, and then when you do cloud comps, you can measure it by the foot.
Yeah.
Like a big ruler.
There's already marks on the wall for that. I want a fat head of Fagin farting right in that same position.
Oh yeah, and just do the vapor cloud coming out of his butt.
Nice. Yeah.
And have the markers right there and see how far you can get it.
Yeah.
Yeah, because after the joint got fogged up that night, it was getting a little tough to see what was going on in there.
Right, yeah.
Hell yeah, it was.
I was glad I video recorded most of it, because even when I couldn't see it live, when I looked at the video version, I could see it. So it was helpful that I did that.
That night when I got back to the hotel room, like, I was so, like, my whole body was just sticky as hell, like, from all the clouds.
I have to take a shower as soon as I get home, because I'm, like, covered in VG.
Yeah, that's bad. You were lubricated.
Exactly.
Ready for a massage with a happy ending.
Speaking of lubricated, Brittany, should I bring up to the panel what happened the other night?
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Please.
You can't not now.
Let the delay kick in and see what her answer is.
You better not say a fucking thing.
Oh, I see Robbie's out there in chat. What's going on, buddy? She told you to shut up.
Shut up.
My guess is that you ran out of lube and you had to use something that was laying around the house?
Pretty close to it.
Canola oil?
It was vegetable oil.
Nice.
Oh, gosh, she's going to castrate you.
Spread is texting right now. You better not say a fucking thing.
Hey, at least your mom doesn't call you during shows.
Yeah, that's kind of creepy that she's done that.
Have you said something to her about that?
She doesn't I keep telling her I do like a YouTube thing, and she doesn't understand. But it's just so weird that the past three shows, she's called every episode.
I was waiting for her to call here shortly.
And as crazy as she is, I would put her on the air, but I won't even want to know what she would say.
Dude, so you got to do that, because I think everybody would love to watch that. Fagan's mom just reaming her out.
My mom's nuts. She's fucking crazy. Like, she's really crazy.
Damn you, Mark.
I told you to get over here and cut this goddamn grass.
So are all your impressions based on your mom?
Kinda.
How far away does your mom live from you, Mark?
Sadly enough, like 5 minutes.
Oh, yeah. So do you see her quite often?
Yes, sadly enough, I do.
Aw, you're a good boy.
I heard Mark was a mama's boy.
Yeah,
sadly enough, I am.
How does she not notice that you don't do anything with vaping with that room right there?
She's just so blind? Out of it. Something. She's just so out of it. She doesn't understand, like, Facebook or YouTube or anything. Like, she's still stuck in technology.
All right, let me ask this. Do you go there all the time, or does she ever come over?
No, I go there.
So she never comes over. She never comes to your house.
She does occasionally, but I normally go over there, drop my son off.
Okay.
But I don't. When I go there, I normally don't vape in the house. Not because I can't. I just normally don't. Because then my dad will be like, you know, I seen those vape things on the news. They're bad for you. They're gonna kill you. I'm like, okay.
Well, now, she's seen your room, though, right? The room that you're in.
She's never been in this room.
Holy crap.
I don't bring her to the vape lair.
Dang.
She would literally shit her pants.
Yeah.
Gonna get all that
Brian wants to know if she'll be on the vape team tonight.
She will. She just won't be on camera.
Yeah. That's Thursday night. She should be at Brian's house, so.
What's even funnier than that if your dad says that stuff? So your dad's never seen that room either?
Nope.
Oh, my gosh. I could only imagine that one.
Is that room hidden behind a rotating bookcase by any chance?
He probably thinks that it's like a whole bunch of sticks of dynamite.
Yeah, they would see this room like, what's all that shit? Why'd you need all that shit?
Hey, Mike.
Yep.
I think what you should do is do a special. Get them live. Just don't let Mark know. And while the show's going on, just let them pop in all of a sudden.
Marky, is that you over there? I can see on the camera, Marky.
What are you doing on TV, Mark? Yeah. Did you notice
that? That is funny.
Yeah, they're
Why do you put the TV behind you? You can't see it then.
Yeah. It's crazy shit.
Oh my god, you got the TV on the wall? It's going to break the wall.
Now, Mark, since we're just getting all up in your business, let me ask you this. Does your mom or dad, have they ever smoked?
Oh yeah, they were heavy smokers. They quit. Both of them? A long time ago. Yeah, both of them, yeah. Okay. I started smoking because they always bought cigarettes by the carton. And They were the type of parents where, like, you know, I'd rather have you do the shit in the house than, you know, outside and sneak around. So I was able to smoke at a young age in my house. Like, I think I was in high school, like, I was able to smoke in the house. Because they already knew I was smoking, and I would just steal cigarettes. So that's how that all got started. Gotcha. But they quit. I think they quit. And I was still smoking.
Someone has to continue the family tradition.
Exactly. And then when I got into, like, rolling my own cigarettes, that was a bitch because they're like, oh, it's so much cheaper. Roll cigarettes for us. So I was rolling cigarettes for three people, and that was, like, a complete nightmare. Like, if you roll your own cigarettes, don't ever tell people you roll your own cigarettes because then they want you to start rolling them for them. And I would spend hours, like, rolling up packs of cigarettes. It was a nightmare.
Are you sure you weren't in a sweatshop?
It felt like it. I wasn't getting paid, so. But I had an awesome, I had an awesome little roll-your-own setup. I had, like, the desktop roller machine. I just had, like, a nice professional setup. And I actually did a roll-your-own video a long time ago. I put it on YouTube, and it got a lot of hits, but I think I took it down when I started vaping. I should have left it up there. It was a pretty cool video.
I would pay money to see that.
Yeah, it was hilarious.
Mark's smoking advice.
what tubes to use, how to roll the tobacco, how not, you know, don't pack it too tight. And it was pretty cool.
Could it be applied in other areas?
Maybe anal sex, but...
All right, real quick down the line, just out of curiosity, what did cigarettes... Who all smoked what, cigarette-wise, before they started vaping?
I smoked Newports.
How about you, Daryl?
Marlboro Reds, and then I switched to Marlboro Special Blend that were, like, medium.
What about you, Daniel?
I'm not sure.
He never smoked.
Okay. What about you, Andrew?
Marlboro Lights.
Mark?
I went from Marlboro to Newport.
Mike?
Newport Lights, Parliament Light Menthols, and then I ended off with Marlboro Light Menthols. I was a menthol smoker.
What about you, Brett?
Sorry. NXTs and Black and Milds.
What about you, Zach?
Whatever I could steal, Camels, you know, Virginia Slims, and then once I was old enough to buy cigarettes, Marlboro Reds, and then Marlboro Lights finally before I switched to vaping.
I was a Marlboro Light person too, so I started on the Reds, but shit, after about 2 years of that and being at a young age, that was still kicking my butt, so I went to Lights. But
Cowboy Killers.
I only started smoking Marlboro because I thought they looked cool and I thought they were cool. Because everybody, like all the cool kids, were always smoked, like, I smoke Marlboro Red.
I used to smoke Marlboro Red. Sorry, I was having a huge delay.
Okay. See, you couldn't steal the Marlboro Reds when I was growing up. They always had the good cigarettes way behind the counter, but they'd have the shitty packs of, like, Pall Malls and stuff like that sitting up front, so you'd be able to snake a pack of those and just deal with it.
And see, that's what sucks. When if you start off on the good stuff, and then you try to go to the cheaper brand, it's like, you can, it's like, ugh, no.
Oh, yeah, you can tell the difference.
Yeah, this is not going to work right here. It's funny how we can pick that up out of smoking a cigarette, what is premium and what's not. So.
Well, yeah, like, I got fiberglass in mine.
I tried smoking Camels one time, and it was like smoking the shit that they swept up off the floor after they made the good cigarettes.
It wasn't any better quality or worse quality. It was just different sets of chemicals that your receptacytes would pick up on, and that's why another brand would taste shitty to you, is because those weren't the chemicals that you were addicted to.
Yeah.
It wasn't just the nicotine. It was the other chemicals that helped it to be more addictive. So that's why a different brand tasted nasty to you, because you were already accustomed to this particular recipe of shit.
Yeah,
I always heard that, like, generic cigarettes, they used, like, the shittiest tobacco leaves, like the shit that was just laying on the ground, or like, and like they would grind up like the stems and everything else, and you just smoke like the shitty tobacco leaf.
Well,
the companies didn't use.
I mean, I believe it's fact too that even the paper that they use, you have a cheaper brand. Or cheaper type paper that they actually roll the cigarettes with, and that creates some of the funk to it, you know.
Yeah. And I tried those Camel, those little, like, flavor packs that you, like, put in the fridge, whatever the hell they were. They weren't, like, the little packs you put, like, on the side of your gum, whatever, and you just kind of suck on them all day.
Oh, Snooze?
Really, yeah. They used to sell them, like, in the little Camel refrigerator behind the counter. Those things were nice for a while.
And see, that's what my old man did before he died. He smoked non-filter cigarettes his whole life. And he smoked for, shit, what, almost 50 years? So.
God damn. ST's dead gangster.
Yeah, he believed in that old school shit. Because I will say this, when I was, 13-ish, 14-ish, I stole a pack of my dad's Camels, and me and a cousin went off somewhere and damn near smoked the whole pack up in a night.
Holy shit.
And by early that morning, I was puking my brains out in the toilet because they weren't filtered. So.
Yeah, my buddy's dad used to smoke Lucky Strike. And every time I bum a cigarette off him, like, oh my God, these things suck. They were non-filtered. They were just horrible.
Hell yeah.
My grandpa, he smoked Tampa Gold cigars. And chewed Levi Garrett. He chewed 3 bags of Levi Garrett every fucking day. And he took me out deer hunting one time, and I told him, I was like, Papa, let me try some of that chew. He said, okay. He'd give me a big old mouthful of it. Dude, I was fucking chewing on that shit, and he never told me to spit, you know, that you got to spit the shit out. You know, so I'm just sitting here swallowing that fucking juice, dude, and it didn't take me fucking 20 minutes. And I was green in the face, throwing up. I never chewed another day in my fucking life. That was the worst sick I've ever been, ever.
All right, well, the tail end of talking about that, let's back it up years now. Do you think vaping would have taken off the way it's taken off now with the generation of people that are doing it, opposed to, say, let's back it up to around the 80s era? With old people that had been smoking a while, do you think people would have still made the swap over from smoking to vaping then, or do you think the mentality of people then were like too old school to say, no, I'm not messing around with this crap?
Be too complicated.
I think they would have tried it if it was out there and available. I think, sure. Sure.
Well, I mean, you got to think in the 90s, especially, everything started, you know, technology started ramping up, so to speak. You know, you had the CD player, you had the everything went portable. So something like this probably would have had a chance back then. I don't know that the technology exactly existed back then, but I think you would have had a damn good shot.
The first e-cigarette was made in 1976 in China.
Yeah, but it was as big as this fucking box, and it sucked dicks.
Clouds, bro, clouds.
Clouds.
Oh, Robbie just told you, he said it was 1963.
Okay, 1963, even earlier than I thought.
Yeah, Brett, Mr. Know-It-All.
Oh, my gosh.
So, Fagan, did you get some mail?
Oh, yeah.
What'd you get there, boy?
Probably nothing exciting.
Did you get a pack full of rubber ears, too?
I hope so. Those things are awesome.
Eat them.
I know if Mike gets a box, that means there's something going on here.
Oh, that's big weird. Boys. I don't know why they sent that to him.
If I'm only really the big boys are getting the rubber ears, what's up with that?
I'm waiting on this FedEx box, and because I don't understand why FedEx keeps, like, not knocking on the door and just leaving a note.
Dude, FedEx passed my fucking shop 3 times this week.
Yeah, and FedEx, no one ever ships anything to me FedEx, so I'm really curious to see what the hell it is. So I don't know where the hell it's at.
That probably will be your box rubber ears in.
I hope so.
Yeah, I finally have an EVIC, a Joytech EVIC Mini coming in from GearBest. Since the beginning of December when they told me they were going to send it. So it only took them 7 weeks. Pretty good. It's pretty timely.
They keep emailing me about the review for the RX200.
Same here, buddy. I guess I got to get one up. I've just been too damn busy with work.
Yeah, I asked for the RX200, and they said, could you pick something less expensive? So I went and bought one myself. Fuckers.
Right. I don't understand how this is going to be considered expensive. But.
I don't know. I don't know the system of how they determine who's worthy of what.
Yeah. Mike, if you get
from Hot Sig, it looks like it's in the RX box.
Oh, so they got a new tank out?
Guess so. Right there.
Looks like the Bellas.
Yep.
How is the Bellas? Anybody here?
It's called a train, right? Train, I think?
Train wreck or something, yeah.
Train vape?
Actually, no, it was derailed. It looks just like a aromamizer, because there are the holes, and then here's the deck. Looks just like the aromamizer.
Yeah.
Better looking. And I think it's a top fill aromamizer.
I was just building an aromamizer.
I did a comment on their picture on Instagram, asking if it was an aromamizer clone, and they replied to that comment telling no, aromamizer is a clone of ours.
Yeah, this is an aromamizer clone.
Yeah,
most definitely.
The aromamizer came out like almost a year ago, and it's a clone of theirs.
Yeah.
When's the Griffin 25mm coming out?
That's what I'm waiting for.
Not yet. I will know soon. They're actually sending me a prototype of their new RDA. I'm going to beta test it for them. It's, what is it again? A Kennedy and a Velocity put together.
Yeah, that thing looks awesome.
Wendy asks, what do you guys think, mods with or without internal batteries?
It depends. For beginners, I like to recommend internal batteries.
Yeah, when I go to vape meets and shit, I like to bring ones that have an internal battery, so I don't have to look around my charger and batteries and shit.
Well, you got the perfect opportunity coming up to take the old RX with 3 batteries to last you. So I can hear you bitch the whole time we're there about, this so thing's heavy. too heavy. It's too big.
It's too heavy. Have you ever used yours all day long to where you have to carry it around all day?
Nope.
Or put it in your pocket to where it weighs down your pocket? It's too heavy. I mean, I probably will use it, but it's just so heavy.
I think I'm going to take the Vape MX with me.
That's a good choice.
I'm going to take the Vape MX.
They
send me with me. Yeah. I'm going to take this Vape MX mod with me.
There you go. Wait a minute, Daniel, do you have the Vape MX device?
No, it was supposed to be the Vape MX device.
No, they probably sent you the wrong package.
I already mailed them.
Yeah, they sent you the wrong package by mistake. I'll bet anything. But I think I'm going to take the Vape MX because it's light, dual 18650, and the battery life is fucking great on this thing.
Nice. Hell yeah.
I'm going to take this Danny Extreme V2 Plus so I can show it off to Daniel when I get there.
Yes, and maybe I can rob you.
We'll be in Detroit, so that would be the customary thing to do.
I don't know, because it is still 1 month away, so we should get more devices, so I really don't know. I'm also expecting the new Dicodes mod.
Oh, yeah,
they have a box 450 with you in Detroit.
No, Daniel has to vape the iJoy product the whole time.
Yeah, man, you don't need to take anything.
He's stuck.
The Reaper tank.
You don't need to take anything with you. You got your stuff supplied there waiting on you.
Yep. You can only vape iJoy shit.
And don't let us catch you out on town vaping something else.
Yeah. I'll take a picture and send it to him.
Daniel Joy's. For your joy.
Can someone please get Daniel a fucking home wrecker while he's in the States?
Yeah.
I will bring mine.
Yeah, I could do that.
Oh, I thought Daniel had one already.
Is it so bad? Shit.
It's not bad. It's just complicated. It requires your level of intricacy.
Okay.
Hell yeah. Daniel, I already tried to get them to send you one. I don't think they want to have nothing to do with you.
Yeah, they don't want. Because they keep telling they don't know me.
Yeah, I told them. I told them who you were. I told them everything. And, I don't think they want to stay away from you.
But Phil Bussard already have his home record, so.
And he loves it before he even got it.
Well, has anybody heard any mention of any, like, big name folks at this convention coming up?
Pegasus Vapor Academy.
Yeah.
I guess Cloud Maker.
Who is she? Even Fagan guy's going to be there.
Yeah, but he'll be downstairs. I won't get to see him much. He'll be down there signing autographs next to the bathroom, so.
Who's this Pegasus chick you're talking about?
Mike Fagan's going to be there.
Nice.
There's the Wotofo Ice Cube.
Ooh.
Wow, they come up with any ideas, don't they?
What's it hold, a 0.5 of juice?
I don't know. No, it's RDA. It's tiny, though.
Wow.
Kind of looks like the fishbone, like a glass inside a glass.
Yeah. It's a little glass cubed.
That'll be sweet for baby clouds.
Yeah, it sure would. Perfect for me.
Are you going to do a quick live look?
Yep.
Why don't you go ahead and do your quick live look now?
Two hours long. Every time I do a video, I always try to make it short as possible. Like, I do everything I can to make it shorter. I can't think of anything else I can do to make it shorter.
You're not very good at making it shorter.
No, I'm not.
He always takes Viagra before his reviews. Makes them longer.
So, Mike, do you feel like that you're going to venture into that? Because I notice, I mean...
No.
All of us have kind of done this so far. You're not going to do a live look at anything?
He does quick first looks. Not live.
No, I'll just do a video. It's faster that way than doing a... Because what happens is when you do the live look and you got the chat going, like with Mark, you're too busy with the chat. The video becomes an hour long or 2 hours long, or in Mark's scenario, 4 hours long, with a lot of looks. So I'd rather just film a quick 5-10 minute video, whatever, just something quick.
Gotcha.
Live look.
I like Mark's long live looks. I can go out to dinner and start playing it and then come back and he's still on there explaining stuff. I still got time to ask questions. I think it's perfect.
Plus, I don't want to bite somebody else's style. Or
I like
you know what I'm saying? Doing a live look. Live shows now, but yeah. I don't want to start doing live looks.
The quality is just so shitty on the live look thing.
Yeah.
That's the only reason why I want to kind of stop doing it, because it's so shitty.
Yeah.
By the way, the thing that disappoints me too.
Let me congratulate Mike. Mike did basically his first live show this past Saturday, and man, that had a hellacious turnout right there, so congrats to you, buddy.
Yes, thank you. Actually, it was a second. You were on my first live show, you and Zach.
Yeah, we did one for about an 18-minute stretch.
Yeah.
So.
Is this working? Am I live? I can't see myself. Can you hear me?
But there was definitely a big turnout on that one, so that was nice.
It was hilarious, too, the whole episode.
Was Dirty on that show, too? I think Dirty was on.
What show was that?
Were you on my first, when I did a live show?
No, I came in after. I didn't see the invite you sent me. I never got
the
invite.
Yeah, I was sitting on the couch watching that show, and Brittany's like, "What's wrong?" I said, you know what? I'm kind of upset. I didn't get a fucking invite to this show. And then after the show goes off, I check my fucking email, and there's an invite.
Yeah.
Like, son of a bitch.
Well, it was definitely a good time on there.
I was watching. It was fun. It was a fun show to watch.
Well, we have hit about the 2-hour mile marker, and I think we're going to bring this to an end. So I appreciate everybody for coming out to watch. And so I'm going to take it down the road again. We'll go the opposite direction, and we'll start it off. Take it away, Zach.
What's up, people? You know where to find me, Zach, vapingmoderation.com, or on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. too many social accounts for me to keep track of. And I will see y'all at VPX Detroit.
Sweet. Take it away, Brett.
What up, guys? My name is Brett. I'm from Southern Gentleman Vape Reviews. Thanks for having me on. And, yeah, hope you guys have a great day.
Mike.
Hi, I'm Mike. Mike Vapes. And thank you for the invite, ST.
Yes, sir.
And make sure everybody watches tonight, the Vape Team, to see the world premiere of Mark Vapes on the Vape Team. And, yeah.
Sweet. Mark.
Thank you for having me on the show. You guys can check me out on YouTube or Not Another Vape Show on Sunday. We'll have Matt from Suck My Mod on there, along with Mr. Brett, Mr. ST, probably Andy, maybe Mike. I don't know who's going to be on there yet, but check me out on the Vape Team tonight, and that's it. Thank you for having me.
Is he really coming?
Yeah, he's really going to be there this time.
That's awesome.
You paid him.
I paid him, and I told him the check's not going to clear until...
It's post-dated.
Yeah.
All right, Andrew.
If you need to borrow some money, Mark, let me know. I'll put up.
Take it away, Andrew.
Bye, Felicia.
Daryl.
Hi, guys. Daryl Sheridan, Quest for Vape. Good seeing you all this week.
Sweet. Daniel.
Hi guys, I'm Daniel, DJLSB Vapes. Thanks for having me again. Go check out my website, djlsbvapes.com. I have giveaways running there, including the UL Rafale tank, 10 Rafale tanks. That's it.
Nice. Dirty.
Hello, you can find me on dirtiesmind.com or youtube.com/dirtiesmind. Thanks again for having me on ST Vapes, the one and only midweek morning vape show around.
Nice.
All
right, folks, we will catch you same time, same place next week. So let me take a little page out of Mike's book and let's hit that shit and get on out of here.
Yes.
My vapa.
Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Peace. Bye.
Bye. Bye.